I'm Tracy Scott and I'm 43 years old and I'm from Brackenfell in Cape Town. I've had excellent health. I never had any issues. The only operations I've had were C-sections, tonsils taken out. Health was excellent. I had no complaints. December 2014, I had vertigo experience for about a month. Husband took me to the doctor. They broke it down to a middle ear infection, gave me motion sickness tablets and said, well, there's nothing else they can do for me. And that happened for the entire month, and once the month was over, the vertigo left me as if it had never even appeared.
MS tas die liggaam aan deur demelanisasie te veroorsaak. Om dit te verduidelik is soos om na 'n elektriese koord te kyk. Jy het jou elektriese draad en rondom dit het jy 'n isolerende materiaal.
Exactly a year later, December 2015, the vertigo hit again. Sat with the rest of the month with vertigo, and again it disappeared like the thief in the night.
So het jy die senuwee en rondom die senuwee het jy mielien skede. In 'n inflammatoriese proses val hierdie mielien skede aan. Dit is soos wat die elektriese draad se isolasie versteur of onderbreek en dan kan die elektriese geleiding nie plaasvind nie.
6 months later, June 2016, I became completely lame in the left arm. This arm did whatever it wanted to do. I couldn't wipe a counter. If I'd say arm go this way, no, the arm was going that way.
Met MS tas dit senuwee aan, maar hoofsaaklik die sentrale senuweestelsel, so met ander woorde jou koord en die brein. Anders is met 'n beroerte, tas dit nie net een spesifieke area van die brein aan nie, maar jy kry wisselende areas wat aangetast is. So die pasiënt se simptome lokaliseer nie net op een plek nie.
So I knew something was wrong, and immediately I made an appointment to see my GP. He said to me, look, we need to see a physician. He thought it might be multiple sclerosis. I thought, no, it can't be. There's no MS in the family. There's never been MS in the family as far as we know. Let's just first see what the physician has to say. Went for the visit with the physician, who ran a few tests, asked me to hold up arms. This arm was wonky, didn't want to stand still. I tell you, it was like a robot. It wanted to do just what it wanted to do on its own. And he said to me, you know, look, we need to do an MRI. And I thought, no, why an MRI? Immediately the next morning after the MRI, he phoned me and he said, Tracy, we found lesions on the brain. So things actually drastically changed from that moment, because you realized where to from here. You know, is this going to affect my life? How is it going to affect my life? Am I going to be okay? Am I going to die? What's going to happen to my family? You think everything you can and you're angry.
Vroeger het omtrent al die pasiënte met die diagnose van MS rolstoelgebonde geraak, later afhanklik geraak van verpleegsorg.
So he said, we need to get you in for a lumbar puncture immediately. And at the time, it was my son's birthday party. It was my husband's golf tour. I said, no, we can do it next week. He said, no, you can't. You need to come tomorrow. And went for the lumbar puncture at the time, hospitalized for a few days. And it came back that the spinal fluid predicted, yes, no, it's definitely MS. I was very sad, because I am a very busy person. It comes in the family. We're very busy people. We love baking, we love cooking, we love looking after our family. I said, this can't stop my life.
'N pasiënt met MS moet baie goed opgelei wees om bedag te wees op 'n relapse.
For the 2 years after that diagnosis, I was literally hospitalized monthly for flare-ups or relapses.
Hulle moet gewoonlik dan vir 5 tot 7 dae in die hospitaal kom, dan rol soos hierdie pasiënte met hoë dosering steroïde.
You know, your whole life changes in that you're that busy person and you want to be that busy person, but you can't, because your body is not allowing you to. Your mind is controlling your body and your nervous system is just, it's absolutely havoc. The only way of medicating yourself was with the daily injections. And a company came along and invented a tablet that, which was equal to the same cost as the injections were. And I've been on that for the last 3 years, where I haven't had any new lesions. I haven't had any flare-ups. It's really manageable. And it's been quite a miracle worker in just having a little bit more of a positive attitude on life.
As jy dit vroeg genoeg kry, heeltemal omkeer. Maar soms kan jy hom net terugbring tot weer 'n stabiele vlak. Daar's baie keer dan 'n trapsgewyse agteruitgang. Dit is wat jy probeer verhoed deur die pasiënt vroeg genoeg te diagnoseer met sy relaps.
You don't really have a choice. You've got two children that you need to bring up. You've got a life that you've been given that you need to live with. These are the cards that you've been dealt. You either live with it or you live against it. You've got to be positive, because without positivity, you are going to land up losing most of your life.